On this week's episode of the DevOps Lab, we have a very special guest with us, Kyle Ruddy. Tune in with us as we go over Terraform version 1.0 and its stability feature release. Welcome back to the DevOps Lab. I'm April Edwards, and with me this week, I have Kyle Ruddy. Welcome, Kyle.
Hey, thanks for having me, April.
Awesome to have you back. Now, you and I have been on the show before. This time I'm hosting and you're my guest. So tell us, Kyle, what are we going to be talking about this week?
This week, we are going to be talking about Terraform 1.0, this major milestone release that has just been dropped and able for everybody to start using it.
Yes. And I've been on the show with you before. We've talked about different versions of Terraform. What's kind of like the biggest headline of version 1.0 that's come out?
I mean, really, when you think about what's coming in Terraform 1.0, it's like I'll take the notes from one of our engineers. And when we say features, there are no new features. No new features. But it's kind of exciting because that brings a whole lot of capabilities and functionality to the table that may or may not have been there, or at least you might not have noticed before.
That's awesome. So the first time I talked about Terraform and Azure on the DevOps Lab, I believe I was using version 0.11 for my code, which is cool. So 0.11 had a lot of kinks in it, but it was stable, but it just had things, right? It had, I like to say, there be dragons, right? Some things would happen and, you know, we got it resolved. 0.12 came out. 0.12 was a massive relief for Terraform, wasn't it? So in 0.12, we kind of changed a little bit of the formatting of the code. We got some stability in there. We added some feature sets. And with each release of Terraform, there's definitely been an increase in features. So this is really cool to see that we're getting stability. So tell us, you know, when people are looking to go to 1.0, what's compatibility like from different versions? What can they expect? What are we going to do?
Yeah, so actually we have a fantastic page that's available on the Terraform site that covers this exactly and talks about the compatibility promises that are being, you know, released as part of the Terraform 1.0 release. And really this just goes out to cover a couple of these things that, you know, really, you know, in the past, you know, maybe there have been some issues, maybe there have been some problems, maybe there have been some processes, some workflows to go through that upgrade process, as you were talking about with 0.11, you know, because now what we're trying to do here is make sure that if your code, your Terraform code works with Terraform 1.0, it's going to continue working throughout the entire 1.0 lifecycle. So it's really a huge, you know, feature capability that's coming as part of 1.0 just to give you, you know, those kind of internal warm and fuzzies that your code is going to continue to work, you know, as the versions continue to iterate across.
Yeah, because that was always the biggest question I had from people. And when I, you know, had my code in 0.11, if I didn't have time to upgrade to 0.12, was always the question, well, do I upgrade it? Do I not? So if someone's on version 0.14 or 0.15, how do they get to 1.0? Because that stability is going to be crucial for a lot of our customers.
So we have a great page on the Terraform site for that as well that kind of walks through the upgrade process for that. And I'll actually give you a little bit of a sneak peek here because some people kind of miss this in the process here, in the release process. You know, if you're on 0.15 already, you can upgrade directly to 1.0 because underneath the covers, Terraform 1.0 was 0.15.5. So sneak peek there, kind of a hidden treasure there. But then even if you go backwards to like say 0.14, for the most part, you should be able to jump right to 1.0. And then we have a couple of, you know, we have an outline here of the different versions and kind of what it looks like to upgrade. And really the biggest point here is that once you get to a certain area, say 0.14, you don't have to worry about making code changes. You don't have to worry about, you know, upgrade tools or things of that nature. You can go directly to it and not really have to worry, you know, is my code going to work? How do I get there? Or anything along those lines.
Absolutely. And that's awesome because we have so many people that are embracing infrastructure as code the first time and want to, you know, DevOps infrastructure. Great. But, you know, that version issue is certainly, you know, a big thing that preys on people's minds. So what happens when a customer has maybe different versions in their environment because they have multiple environments and or, you know, multiple subscriptions or multiple everything in their Azure subscription? How do they handle that?
So definitely go through and figure out what version you're currently on, and then check out these upgrade guides, because we have different upgrade guides that go all the way back to 0.7. So, you know, you could feel comfortable knowing that, you know, check out the guide, see what kind of, you know, hills that you might be running into, and follow the process to get upgraded.
Awesome. Cool. So is that it for version 1.0, just stability?
That is.
Wow.
I mean, it's a tremendous thing. It's one of those things that when you think about it and you look in the past, you know, say that 0.12 that came out with HCL2, you know, that was a huge feature that was released as part of that. And when you look at 1.0, this is one of those areas where it's really the culmination of 7 years of engineering work, you know, 1,500 different contributors from the community that have been out there making Terraform, you know, really turning it into what it is today. And plus, you know, we're at over 100 million downloads of the open source binary. So, you know, this is really the time when HashiCorp gets really serious about their version releases. And 1.0 is that huge milestone release where, you know, we really try and focus in on the stability of the product to make sure that it's going to work as promised, so that you have the comfort in using Terraform for all your infrastructure needs.
Awesome, Kyle. Thank you so much. Really appreciate this update on version 1.0. I think the stability is important. I'm a massive fan of Terraform. I use it quite a lot. So if anyone's ever watched the DevOps Lab, they'll have seen all my series on it. This is great to see. Thank you so much for joining us today. And thank you everyone for tuning in, and join us next time on the DevOps Lab. We're going to have some more Terraform knowledge from Kyle Ruddy coming up in the next episode.